Together Together is everything you could want in a romantic comedy, minus the romance. Sort of. Spoiler alert. That doesn't happen. But their relationship grows more complicated as they come to rely on one another. The concept of platonic love comes directly from director Nicole Beckwith's experiences with deep friendship. Some of my most formative loves have been platonic loves of my life and where I felt very seen and very understood and celebrated, and I celebrate that person, she says. Harrison empathizes with those experiences. Some of my best friendships feel romantic in the level of openness and love that you feel for the person, the passion that you can feel for friends. The movie plays with expectations. It's commentary a little bit on the genre itself, she says. Helms says he hadn't read a script like this one before. It's not a story that we see out there, a middle-aged straight guy wanting to be a parent through surrogacy, he says. That alone felt special. We can thank fairy tales for our societal obsession with romance, Beckwith says. We've been brainwashed from a very early age to think of that as paramount. A relationship not continuing on over the horizon is seen as a failed relationship, Beckwith adds, a notion Together Together chips away at. A deep friendship still affected you, she says. It held an important place in your life for however long that was and shaped you in those ways. Ergo, the platonic rom-com. The platonic rom-com formula can be more commonly found in movies where female friendships are tested amid growing pains like Life Partners, Frances Ha, and Bridesmaids. Typically, that story involves a significant other coming into the picture who challenges the relationship. In the case of Together Together, that's replaced with the imminent arrival of a baby. Annie, Kristen Wiig, in Bridesmaids, feels out of place at Lillian's, Maya Rudolph, engagement party, when the real issue at hand is that their friendship is about to change. Together Together features a similar scene where Anna doesn't fit in at Matt's baby shower. That's part of what makes this movie so special is that it subverts some of those tropes and expectations in a very gentle and compassionate way, Helms says. The film also subverts expectations without ever acknowledging it on screen. Anna is a cisgender female character and Harrison is transgender, an atypical casting choice in Hollywood, where transgender actors are typically relegated to transgender roles, if they're cast at all. It's a space that has been predominantly almost all white and straight and cis, Harrison says. Identity wasn't something Beckwith focused on in the casting process. She says she cast the best person for the role. Harrison is a gifted actress, a riveting performer, an incredible person, and as soon as I saw her, that was my Anna, Beckwith says. She hopes Hollywood opens up opportunities for transgender people going forward.